Hello to you, it's Salty and today's review on Lictum Battle Mage. Creating games only for money becomes something normal long ago, so despite good rating, this game is not that different. Some group of people have compiled their random ideas and then worked a lot to clear angles of it. It's look like that. Lictum reminded me a lot of old games and even some books. This game is good, but in overall could be better. Like developers tried, but not brought their work to the end. I don't know if it was enough money or time, but game even has some bugs. In my licensed Steam copy. Not critical ones, the most of them in the animation. So, the game is based on CryEngine 3. Due to this and good designer's work, the game looks really nice. Sometimes I just stop for beautiful scenery, views, nature, swamps, lava and ice, how the light passes through leaves and other stuff. CryEngine 3 is really great. Actually, it's the first good side from two of this game. The second is gameplay. It brings some real fun, I expected less. But the battles are really great. Only because of these two moments I played the game to the end. And if you would like simple gameplay, clear actions that only needs a bit of skills and reaction, else you have a good computer to play, this game is for you. You know, if you ask me for the game without RPG components with first-person view in fantasy world, the first I will remember is The Dark Messiah. I can't remember the game with similar idea from the good ones. So, seems it's kind of unique, you only magic, battles and fun. Yes, from the start it's a lot of fun from smashing people into pieces with fire, brings the apocalypse around you, searching for tactic for bosses. The fun is a really good side of this. And I can't say so about spellcrafting system. It's just for making your power better and all, but pretends to be something great. Really nothing special. The system has manual and automatic crafting. But when after good battles you will get about 20 craft items, I really don't think that someone will craft spells manually. So I simply used automatic system all the game and it was enough. I slightly passed through with this. You simply combine some magic items to get better spells and combine these items with each other to get better. And that's all. Simple enough. Also, you're upgrading your shield. Actually, I have 3 shields that restore itself automatically. But when one shield is destroyed fully, you need to find some mechanism which will restore it. Usually, it appears somewhere between waves of enemies. I really like this idea. Shield actually is your health. So automatic health restoration is just a annoying thing for me from the consoles. But in the same moment, in this game, it's not. The most difficult enemies is bosses and some demons, but who said difficult? Maximum after 5 battles against them you will understand how to defeat each enemy group or boss. Enemies not too smart. This game is not trying to be hard. It's just for relax and spend some hours. But the overall idea is good enough to have an audience. Yes, there are a lot of games were released in 2014 where you need only to kill enemies, but most of them are in the military setting that I'm really tired of. The story of the game is something background. You are the dragon. Magic warrior who received his power from the wizard with name Rot to fight dark forces to the end. They named something like Cult of Malthus. Here is no need for big story, really. It even has an annoying part, some memories from the past that you may open during the game. After you watch them, you will get spell components, and it's the only reason to spend your time on it. They will not really help you to understand the world, even characters. There are some magic schools named Sigils to learn, like lightning, fire, ice and others, but they're only a matter of taste. You really need only to select 2 of them and combine it like I'm combining the first ones, kinetic and fire. With first ones, it was very easy to path through the game. I tried others, but they were not very powerful because I spent a lot of time to improve my first. And some of them really not too different from each other. From time to time, game offers what skills you would like to learn, but from around the middle of the game, it's starting to be useless. I think it's really overrated by critics. It even doesn't fully test it. There are some bugs like wide opened mouths, bad animated hands, clothes and other stuff. And in the round of third part of playing, it's starting to be boring. No new enemies there, similar bosses, etc. The game is totally lacks the scale. The plot does not go on increasing at an end. The city did not explode, the towers doesn't fall, enemies doesn't smash walls, walls of the caves not crumble. Exactly this is the sign of the great game with rating 8 and above from 10. I will not remember this game after some months. The game does not deserve more than 6 from 10. The only thing that enjoyed until the last moment of playing was scenery. Even the small story of the game developers ruined. You will understand why if you will play it. Okay, maybe 7 from 10, but not 8. Just feeling that the developers took a cool engine, made beautiful surroundings and just relaxed it. Just say something like, that's enough, people will buy it. The game leaves mixed feelings. If you want to play something simple and relaxing, this game is for you. If you expect something more, better not. This was Celty and Lichdom Battle Mage. Thank you for watching.